Hey, this is Dr. A, and in this video, let's go over the skeletal system diagnostic and therapeutic procedures. All right, we're going to start with diagnostic procedures. An arthrogram is an x-ray record of a joint. So anytime you have gram, it's a record. And then arthro means joint. So therefore, arthrography is visualizing a joint by x-ray after injecting contrast medium into a joint. So graphy is the process of getting the record that then is a gram, right? A bone scan is a nuclear medicine procedure. It uses radioactive dye to visualize bones. It is useful for identifying stress fractures and then tumors and metastases. Dual energy absorptiometry, or DXA, measures bone density using low-dose x-ray, and it detects osteoporosis. Myelography is a study of the spinal column after injecting opaque contrast medium. It is useful for identifying herniated nucleus propulsus or a slipped disc. Or bulging disc. That's not a slip disc. That's a bulging disc. I'm sorry. A radiograph is an x-ray. Radiography, it is a process of getting an x-ray. So it uses x-rays to study the internal structure of the body. It is especially useful for visualizing bones in joints. An arthroscope is an instrument used to view inside of a joint, and arthroscopy is examining the interior of a joint with an arthroscope, a fiber optic camera. The view of the joint interior appears on a monitor during the procedure. So just like gram and graphy, we have scope and scopy. So scope is the instrument that you use to view. If you need to, you just think microscope, right? But this is arthroscope. And then scopy is the process of using the scope. And so microscopy or arthroscopy here to make some parallels. All right, let's talk about some medical procedures. We have arthrocentesis is the insertion of a needle into a joint cavity to remove fluid. So that centesis is that needle puncture removal of fluid. And arthro is joint. Orthotic is a brace or splint that is used to prevent or correct deformities. A prosthesis is an artificial device to substitute for a missing or damaged body part. An amputation is the removal of a limb for reasons like tumors, gangrene, or a crushing injury. Arthroplasia is forcibly breaking loose a fused joint. That would be to restore movement. Arthrodesis is the stabilizing of a joint by fusing bones together. This is often done in the spinal column where you fuse one vertebrae with another. Arthroscopic surgery is performed in surgery while using an arthroscope to view inside the joint. Arthrotomy is cutting into a joint. A bone graft is harvesting bone from one location to replace a bony defect in another location. So that would be on the same person. Bunionectomy is the removal of the bursa at the base of a great toe, which causes a bunion. Bursectomy is the removal of a bursa. Chondrectomy is the removal of cartilage. Chondroplasty is a repair of cartilage. Craniotomy is cutting into the skull. It's usually a cutting to remove pressure. Laminectomy is a removal of the posterior arch of the vertebrae to remove compression of a spinal nerve. So it's usually compression of the bone on the spinal cord nerve. So if you can remove part of that bone, you allow for more space for that nerve. Osteoclasia is the intentional breaking of a bone. An osteotome is an instrument used to cut bone. Osteotomy is cutting into a bone. Percutaneous discectomy is a tube is inserted into the intervertebral disc to suck out a ruptured disc and it may also be done with a laser. Spinal fusion is the surgical immobilization of two adjacent vertebrae, so next to each other you fuse them together. And synovectomy is the removal of a synovial membrane. A total hip arthroplasty, or THA, is the implanting of a prosthetic hip joint. And a total knee arthroplasty is the implanting of a prosthetic knee joint. So these are two of the most common surgical procedures that we do, especially with osteoporosis in falls. So people either break a hip or have bad knees. So let's talk a little bit on the pharmacology terms. So we have bone reabsorption inhibitors. They reduce the reabsorption of bone to treat osteoporosis and Paget's disease. Examples are Boniva and Fosamax. Calcium supplements and vitamin D therapy are supplements that help maintain bone density. They can treat osteomalacia, osteoporosis, and rickets. Ostercal and citracal are two examples. Corticosteroids have strong anti-inflammatory properties. They are used to treat rheumatoid arthritis and other autoimmune conditions. Prednisone, Medrol, and Decadron are all examples. And then non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, also known as NSAIDs, provide mild pain relief and are anti-inflammatory. They are used to treat arthritis. They are milder than the corticosteroids. And examples are Advil, Motrin, Aleve, aspirin, ibuprofen. And that wraps up our pharmacology, our medical treatment and procedures for the skeletal system. Thank you all.